All right, everybody, welcome to our next lesson here. So, the impact of industrialization. So, our objective and standard is to explain the challenges faced by the South in industry and agriculture in the late 1800s and to describe the impact of industrialization in the late 1800s. And please read the standards if you would, please. And our desired result. What were some of the effects of industrialization on the United States? So, struggles for the South. Following the Civil War, the North is going to boom with industry while the South is going to kind of fall behind. Now, there were some pockets of success in industry in the South, such as in tobacco processing, stone quarrying, which is basically breaking apart stones and things like that for buildings and other purposes, and also furniture making. Now, some cities, such as Atlanta, Georgia, and Knoxville, Tennessee, did grow strong and develop. They had like electric streetcars and things that you might see in the North. But, however, most of the South is going to struggle with economic and social obstacles to industrialization. We'll talk about some of those problems later on today. So while the North is going to continue to industrialize and use factories and machinery, the South is going to really remain largely based on agriculture and farming. So the New South. Eventually, there are going to be calls by some for industrial growth in the South, such as Henry W. Grady, a newspaper editor in Atlanta, Georgia. He's going to call for something called a New South that is going to include industry. So prior to the Civil War, the South had shipped raw materials such as cotton, wood, and iron ore to the North and overseas. But during the 1880s, Southerners are going to begin to grow their own industries, such as cigar and lumber production, along with coal, iron, and steel processing centers. Now, agriculture had also expanded in the South to include more options, such as grain, tobacco, and fruit as well. So we're moving away from the Old South, which is strictly based a lot on cotton prior to the Civil War, and moving towards these more open industries and more industrial industries. That's why it's called the New South. So joining railroads. The growth of industry in the South meant the need for more reliable transportation, so Southern rail lines are going to begin to grow and expand as well. Now, the growth of railroads also led to the expansion of cities such as Mobile, Alabama, Montgomery, Alabama, New Orleans, Louisiana, and also Charleston, South Carolina. But despite growth by the railroads in the South, there were only two rail lines to northern markets, to Chicago and to New York City. So again, even though the South is trying to expand and trying to grow in industry, still a lot of struggles going on there. So struggles remain for the South. Although changes came to the South, many areas still fell behind in terms of economic development. The South was still struggling and trying to rebuild from the Civil War, which, if you can remember, maybe some of your history about the Civil War, the South was pretty devastated by the Civil War. There had been a lot of fighting in the South, a lot of crops and farms had been destroyed, a lot of lives had been lost, property destroyed. So the South is really trying to just kind of get back on its feet following the Civil War, and it's really having a hard time doing so. Now, while the South had a lot of natural resources to build industry and to industrialize, it lacked the labor or investment to support those industries. So that's a problem. Many workers in the South were also not trained or educated to work in industry. You know, a lot of people in the South were used to farming and, you know, had grown up on farms, or that's what they had taught, that's what they've been taught since they were children. So that's what they pretty much knew was farming. So, you know, it's just like if you throw me up on, you know, an electrical pole and tell me fix this electrical pole, why I don't have any training in electrical poles. You know, I don't have any training in that background of, you know, fixing electricity and electrical poles. So, you know, I'm not going to be that good at it. So, you know, throwing these farmers and people whose lives have been based in farming into factories and working with machinery, you know, it's not going to go so well. There were also low wages, so low pay for people, and a lack of education. The North had a lot of schools, and in northern areas, and the South really didn't have a lot of schools or access to education. So many people don't want to move to the South. Many people don't want to necessarily maybe stay in the South. So this is also hurting them that people don't want to come to the South because it's not seen as economically successful. So issues with farms. Remember that most Southern planters were concentrated on cotton and tobacco before the Civil War. Now, during the war, especially at the end of the war, cotton production is going to fall to very low levels at the end of the fighting, and Europeans had been buying cotton from the South prior to the Civil War. But when cotton levels fall to a very low supply during the war, Europeans, such as the English, are going to look elsewhere for cotton supply, so they're not going to buy from the South. So that's going to hurt the South after the war. They might go to the British and say, "Hey, come on back, we can sell you some cotton," but the British are going to go, "Oh, we already found somebody else to sell us that cotton. Thanks, but no thanks." So that's going to hurt a lot of cotton farmers, obviously, in the South. Another problem is this, kind of creepy looking creature here is something called the boll weevil. Now, the boll weevil is an insect that can destroy an entire crop of cotton. And in the late 1800s, this insect is going to cause major problems for cotton farmers across the South as well. So let's talk about some other effects of industrialization. Let's take a look at the world markets here, the pro side or the good side. So we're going to see American exports of grain, steel, and textiles, which is like clothing and fabric, dominate international markets. People are going to be buying from the Americans. People are going to be, wanting to come to the U.S. to buy those products. And also, the United States is going to have miles and miles of railroad, that they can transport goods quickly and easily. Now, the con to this, or the bad side of this, is that the United States is going to kind of clash with other economic and political views of other world countries. And you'll see that as we get into the 1900s and so, and of course, throughout the course during the year, that the United States is going to clash with some other countries over economic policies or political policies. So that's kind of a con to that. In terms of daily life, the pro, many Americans are going to move to the cities for work and lifestyle changes, and this is going to give them easy access to goods and services as well. Of course, the railroad and mass production of things, people are going to be able to afford things more. We'll begin to see a lot of goods and services made cheaper to people, so that's a good thing. But the con to this is it's a high cost of living, especially in the cities. And cities especially have very dangerous living and working conditions because of industrialization. So again, we'll talk more about that later on. And the environment. So as industrialization begins to spread across the country, many people are realizing that, maybe industry is doing some damage to the environment, and the government is going to begin setting aside national parks or protected areas to protect the environment because of these concerns. But the other con to this is that, there's still a lot of pollution and there's still a lot of industrial waste. Sorry, I have a typo there. And damage to the environment that's going to raise concerns by Americans. But we'll see those issues begin to be addressed as well when we begin to talk about the progressive era at the end, beginning of the 1900s. All right, so our closure again. What were some of the effects of industrialization in the United States? Think about, how industry is trying to grow and impact the South and the New South. Think about some of the pros and cons we talked about there in the previous slide about the impact on world markets and daily living and the environment as well, and that will help you answer your question. Include this information in your weekly summary, please. Let me know of any questions or concerns, and I hope to talk to you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.